When people give, connected to people and vote to vote, democracy is created. Voters keep connecting, creating new connections. Matdata Junction, hashtag Matdata Junction. Matdata Junction, hashtag Matdata Junction. A warm welcome to Matdata Junction, the weekly program of India's Election Commission. So, Bharti?
Yes, Bharat, my friend. In keeping with the weekly trend, let's to Matdata Junction our voices lend. How was that?
Wow, Bharti. Now that's amazing. I remember your extempore, your impromptu skills very well. And this skill of yours seems to have been inculcated in you since childhood.
Now, what on earth did I even say that you have started reciting ballads in my honor? Let's start the program now, yes. As we need to value time as well.
Yes, you're absolutely right, Bharti. Mm-hmm. I firmly believe that our listeners and all the countrymen celebrated National Voters Day on the 25th of January and Republic Day on the 26th of January with great enthusiasm.
Oh, definitely. Is this something to even remind one of or ask about?
Bharati, in reminding, I'm also reminded that I have memories of all the votes I've cast till date. And you know what? I also remember the days when my grandparents and parents would take us along when they went to the polling booth to cast their votes.
You're right, Bharat. Together with sweet memories of our childhood, several election mechanisms are also deeply ingrained in our minds. You know, how political parties would take out rallies.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yes.
And do you know, Bharat, I had even collected a number of badges of small symbols.
Oh, wow. That's nice.
What a beautiful childhood we had. And then dressing up to go to the polling booth. And though we knew that as we were kids, the ink mark, you know, would not be applied on our fingertips. Yet, I would persist mom to get the marking done. And she would quietly put a mark with her nail polish. And oh, how happy I would then be.
I can very well imagine. I can relate to that. Yes, Bharati. I would also, you know, ask my father about that mark. I still remember he had explained that every voter's finger is marked with this indelible ink. That is an ink that cannot be wiped off easily.
Right.
To make sure that no voter can cast his vote a second time in the same elections. And we would keep checking this mark on his finger for months, remember?
Those were simple days. Hey, Bharat. Listen. What is the town crier announcing? Can you hear?
Is there an election
rally somewhere?
Yeah. I can hear.
Come. Let's listen.
Hear all, villagers. Lend me your ears. You are hereby informed that Electoral Uncle has called all of you to the village council tomorrow evening at 4 p.m. All villagers, brothers and sisters, are requested to reach on time. Hear all.
Oh my, Brother Ram Sivak, what is the matter? Why has Electoral Uncle called all villagers for a meeting?
Brother Badru, we can get to know that only tomorrow.
Come, let us inform the other villagers too, though the town crier is trying hard to reach everyone.
But still, let us also do a bit.
My dear brothers and sisters, we have called all villagers to this meeting today because elections are on the cards and many of our villagers still do not have the voter ID cards. Some have not yet enrolled their names in the voter list. So while there is still time, get your voter ID corrected and link it with your Aadhaar. And those who have not yet made their ID cards should immediately apply along with all necessary documents. Our dear Kalpana is also present amongst us today to inform and enlighten us on many such important issues. Here's our dear Kalpana.
Greetings to all of you. As Electoral Uncle has just said, elections are nearing, and this time we want that there should be 100% voting from this village, and you all can choose your candidate by participating in the elections.
See, my dear brothers and sisters, you should not feel that going to cast your vote is a difficult task. Some people will wonder if proper arrangements would be made for tackling the crowd. Some might worry about how long they would have to stand the queue. Yes, Ramsava, why have you raised your hand? Do you want to ask something?
Uncle, my father is 80 years old. He cannot stand at a stretch for too long.
Got your point, Namsavang. Got your point. Now everyone please listen carefully. Some basic facilities are provided by the Election Commission at every polling booth so that no voter faces much trouble, be it an elderly person or a common voter. The first important thing is that the polling booth in every polling station is set up on the ground floor so that there is no problem in reaching the booth. Batlu, hope you did not face any problem last time.
No, Electoral Uncle. My mother cannot use her legs at all. How could she have cast her vote if the booth had not been at the ground level? Isn't it, Ram Sevak?
Yes, that's true. My father too was very happy as he was provided with the facility of a wheelchair immediately. A volunteer in no time escorted him from the ramp to the polling station and helped him cast his vote. My father blessed him abundantly.
Ram Sevak ji, there are separate entry and exit points for voters at polling stations to control the crowd, and there are help desks at every polling station for the convenience of voters, where an attempt is made to solve your problem instantly.
Yes, madam. We saw all this. Last time, our names were not found in the list. The people at the help desk made the work easy.
All of you, do download the Voter Helpline app on your mobile. Your mobile itself will serve as a help desk for you. What is only necessary is for all of you to take a pledge to cast your vote. Rest of the facilities will be taken care of by the Election Commission. Right, Uncle?
Yes, yes. From drinking water to toilet, from RAM to volunteering, everything. Even being definitely able will not be a hindrance in voting. Braille inscription on EVM for the visually impaired, deployment of trained officers at the polling stations for the deaf and dumb, and yes, even separate queues in the polling stations for the convenience of the differently abled and the elderly voters. All you have to do is to make up your mind to cast your vote.
Yes, yes. Voting is a festival of democracy. Do not take it as just a task. Together with work, there is a joy of celebrations too. So, Brother Badlu, what do you think?
You are right, Kalpana, madam. This time, each and everyone from our village will go to cast their votes.
Do keep in mind, okay? We have to make this village number one.
We are many tongues and many tribes, complete as one, for no bondage, no pride. Grass, Lord, freedom and peace. Take your vote and make it worth. Give us strength to stand for a right. Cast a vote.
This time, each and everyone from our village will surely go to cast their votes.
Brother Ram Sevak, I also reaffirm that this time we shall make sure that every member casts his vote.
Hey, that's really great!
Ram Sevak and Badlu, now that's the spirit. Look, election is an important program for all of us, and the Election Commission always tries to ensure that the voters get all the proper facilities to cast their votes. Overall conclusion is that the Election Commission, realizing the importance of each voter, makes ample preparations for the voters. So isn't it our duty also to respect these efforts and come forward to celebrate this festival with great enthusiasm?
But Uncle, we miss one important point.
And what is that, Kalpana?
In the next election, there will be a competition for selection of an ideal polling station. For this, a team of youth from the village are getting ready and are already geared up, and all are very excited.
Well, well, that's amazing.
As responsible electorate, come forward and participate. Young and old, all above 18 years old. Young and old, all above 18 years old. Don't shy away. Don't shy away. And must take part on election day. Whom to elect, whom to reject. Exercise your voting rights. It's you. Yes, it's you who decides.
And listeners, do tell us how you find the Election Commission's program Matdata Junction. We welcome your opinions and suggestions.
And also, listeners, you can participate in our program. See, after a brief introduction on any topic related to voting, send us just 1 minute recording in your own voice. Recording of any song or poem written by you. Once selected by our jury, we shall broadcast it in our program.
Right, so for today's program, a slogan has been recorded and sent to us by students of 7th and 9th grade, Shaurya and Vanshika. Bharat, see, we were recalling our childhood days, and look, inspired by our program, even children have sent in their entries.
Very nostalgic.
Come, let's listen to them.
Yeah, I'm dying to.
My name is Shaurya. I am a student of class 7.
And my name is Vanshika. I am a student of class 9.
We appeal to all of you,
please do go and cast your votes. When all of you cast your vote, the right candidate you can spot. If you refrain, progress you cannot gain. It's your right, it's your duty, fulfill with priority. Thank you.
Ah, such a wonderful slogan by Vanshika and Shaurya. Isn't it, Bharat?
Oh, definitely.
Before we wrap up this episode, let us share the name of the winner of last episode's quiz.
Yes, yes. The most important section of our program. So, Bharati, what's the question?
Yeah, the question asked in the last episode was, in which year was the National Voters Day started? And the correct answer is 2011.
And the lucky winner selected among the listeners who sent in the correct answer is
Renu Jha, G73, Sector 20, Noida, 201301.
Well, heartiest congratulations to you.
Congratulations.
So your award, courtesy the Election Commission of India, will reach you soon. So Bharati, isn't it now the time to ask the question for today's episode?
Right, Bharat. So please take note of today's question. For the convenience of the voters, on which floor is the polling station or booth generally set up?
I repeat, on which floor is the polling station or the booth generally set up?
And send us your answers by Monday on our WhatsApp number 9999031950. Before we wind up, one very important point.
Oh, yes.
We get many messages with the correct answers, but only the answer without details of name or address.
Now that is what we found out.
So you know what happens, Bharat?
Hmm.
We cannot include them
for
selecting the prize. So we request all of you to please put in a little effort and give us your full details along with your answer. Your message will then definitely be selected for the prize.
And Bharati, I also want to add something, you know.
Sure.
See, friends, do keep sending in your answers to us without worrying whether your name has been chosen as a winner or not.
Right.
Keep the faith. And if not this time, then there's always a next time. What do you say, Bharati?
Absolutely, I agree to that. And now time to take your leave. Next week, same day, at the same time. Do not forget to tune in to Matdata Junction. program of India's Election Commission. Bye-bye.
Matdata Junction, hashtag Matdata Junction. Matdata Junction, hashtag Matdata Junction.